It's an uncanny story. Do you want to share with the audience this movie about the twins, or is it still in
embryo? I mean, it would be easy to write the screenplay because it's such a evident, wonderful story. It's about a real case of twins in England who came from Yorkshire originally. And they are the only known case where twins or two people speak in unison as if connected by telepathy. Of course, if you approach them and knock at their door and they say, hello and wonderful to see you and please come in and could we offer you a cup of tea? Sure, that can be ritualistically trained. Mm. But if you ask them a question they couldn't expect, they would still answer in unison. Mm. Quite often, one of the sisters would speak the first part of the sentence and her sister would accentuate with a key word and then take over the rest of the sentence and the other one would accentuate with a key word. And when they make up their mind, they whisper to each other like chicken and they speak in unison to each other. It's completely strange. And the case was apparently they had a catastrophic childhood with an abusive father who apparently sexually molested them. And they, on the garden, at the fence, there was a garden shed shared with the property next doors where a fat, ugly, purple-faced trucker lived. And he had a relationship. They started a relationship with him, and for years they had a sexual relationship, and they were deeply and madly in love together with him. And one day the trucker tells him, girls, it has to stop because I'm getting married. And they couldn't take it. And they tossed themselves in front of his truck, make him stop and beat him up with in sync with their handbags or with her, poked at him in sync with their umbrellas. And it went on for a couple of years until the truck driver went to court to have a restraining order. And now in British common law, you have to testify alone, but there was an exception in legal history, never happens. They testified in unison together. And they, because the judge was very wise, he saw that they were in immediate panics when they were somehow separated, and they jabbed across the courtroom in sync with their fingers and pointed at the truck driver and yelled, "He's lying. The liar is lying. Don't you hear every word that he says is a lie?" And then it comes, "The bucking bastard is lying." At the same moment, the same slip of tongue, "The bucking bastard." And that's going to be the title of the film. And of course, the trucker got his restraining order, and they flee to an aunt at the edge of the Scottish Highlands, and they immediately take a vow. "We are going to dig a tunnel through this entire mountain because somewhere on the other side there must be a better world." And they know it will take them more, or it will take 15, 20, maybe 30 human consecutive lives until they have drilled through the mountain, and they start it anyway. And in 2.5 years, they are something like 50 feet into the mountain, and they have raised a little fox because hunters had poisoned a fox den, and one little fox survived, and they warm him under their armpits alternatively. And in a year, the fox is grown up and follows them. And in this tunnel, there are cracks on the side, and all of a sudden, the fox disappears. And they are frantic because the fox doesn't come back, and they start to chisel to the side, and all of a sudden the sidewall collapses and they find themselves in a fantastic world of crystal cathedrals and stalactites and stalagmites, and they explore it and they give it names, and then it's night and the fox is found. And next day they put on their wedding gowns. They have their wedding gowns because they know maybe they reach the other end. And all of a sudden they stumble across railroad tracks, narrow railroad tracks, a little bit like Michael Jackson's Neverland train. And all of a sudden a train like this comes passing by full of tourists, and the conductor is explaining about the cave, and they fall in love with a voice. of that conductor, and they follow, and of course for decades this system of caves has been discovered and has been used for tourism, and they walk all day long and follow the tracks, and it exactly at 6 o'clock p.m. sharp they reach the other end, and there's an employee who rattles down this steel sort of Venetian blinds and locks it, and they say, stop, let us out, and he looks at them and is completely perplexed, this employee, and he says, I cannot let you out, nobody can be in there because we had 262 people entering and 262 people exiting. You cut, end of the film.